next element that is copper, and this copper is a mineral which is absorbed as cupric ions from the soil. And the functions of copper include, it acts as an activator of certain enzymes like lactase and oxidase. And these enzymes, lactase and oxidase, are responsible to carry out the redox reaction. Redox reaction is a type of reaction in which oxidation and reduction both takes place. And this redox reaction shows the conversion of cuprous to cupric ions, and this cupric ions is getting converted back into the cuprous form. So this type of reaction is called as redox reacts, which is carried out by the enzymes which activates by the presence of copper, and that are lactase and oxidase. This copper ions also required for the synthesis of ascorbic acid. Ascorbic acid is vitamin C which is present in the citrus plants. So this ascorbic acid is getting synthesized, or it is produced in the presence of copper ions. So these are certain functions which is carried out by the mineral copper. And if the mineral would not present, then what are the deficiency symptoms we can observe in the plant body? Includes exanthema. Exanthema is a condition, or it is the secretion of gum. It is defined as the deposition of gum on the bark. We know that the cock cells or the dead cells are present on the bark, and when we observe the bark, we can see a pore or an opening, and this pore or the opening of the stem or the bark is called as lenticels, and through lenticels the exchange of gases takes place. Now if the copper is absent in the soil, or it is present in the less amount, then what happens? The gum will secrete, or it deposits on the bark of the plant or a tree. So as the gum is deposited on the bark, it even deposits on the pores called lenticels and blocks that pores. When the deposition of the gum takes place even on the part of lenticels, then there will no possibility to exchange the gases. The gaseous exchange would get affected. That means the cellular respiration, will not take place due to the deposition of gum. That results in the necrosis. Necrosis is the death of the tissues. So when the gum is secreted or it is deposited on the lenticels, the exchange of gases stops. That results in the necrosis of the tissues. The death of the tissues takes place due to the deposition of the gum on the lenticels. And because of this, we can find the decrease in the amount of the gases carbon dioxide and oxygen in the plant body. And when the carbon dioxide and oxygen decreases or present in the less amount in the plants, then it would be very difficult to carry certain processes in the plants to be alive. So these are some of the deficiency symptoms, and the one particular symptom or the significant symptom in the deficiency of copper is exanthema, in which we can see the deposition of the gum that blocks the lenticels and that stops the exchange of gases, due to which the necrosis of the plant tissues takes place. The next element or the mineral is boron, and there are many functions which is played by the presence or by the element boron. Let us see some of the functions of boron. The first one is, it helps in uptake and utilization of calcium ions. The boron is essential for membrane functions. The membrane of the cell helps in the transportation of the materials across the membrane. So in the transportation of the substances across the membrane is carried out in the presence of boron. So boron is essential for membrane functions, and this boron is required for pollen grains to stick on the stigma. And this boron is a mineral which is used or which is essential for the major processes like cell differentiation, cell elongation, and even in the cell division. This is also helps in the translocation of carbohydrates from leaves to the storage organs. We know that leaves are the sites for the process photosynthesis. In this process of photosynthesis, the carbohydrate is produced, which is present in the leaves. And this carbohydrate needs to get transported, or it needs to get translocated to the various tissues or to the various cells of the plant body. So this translocation or the transportation of carbohydrate from leaves to the other parts or to the other storage organs is carried out by the presence of element called boron. It is also required for pentose phosphate pathway. PPP stands for pentose phosphate pathway, by which the formation of fruits can take place and also the regeneration of the tissues can occur. This pentose phosphate pathway can be activated, or it can be performed, it can perform actively in the presence of boron. Now let us see some deficiency symptoms of boron. The disease which can be caused due to the deficiency of boron is named as heart rot of beetroot. So this heart rot disease can be seen only in the beetroot. So this disease is named as brown heart disease, because in this type of disease, the tissues or the central part of the plant body will become woody. As it is showing the symptoms on central part, that means the central part of the plant becomes woody, therefore it is named as heart, because heart is the organ which is present or which is located at the central side. So it is named as heart rot of beetroot, which can only be seen in the beetroot plants, not in the other plants. The next is leaf curl. This leaf curl disease can be seen in many plants, as the name itself suggests that the leaf will rolled up or it will become curled. Due to the curling of the leaf, the surface at which the photosynthesis can occur will be lowered. As the surface of the leaf gets curled, there is an effect on the rate of photosynthesis. That means the rate of photosynthesis will get lowered, and even the production of carbohydrate would get affected due to the deficiency of boron. Let us study about the molybdenum. Molybdenum is a mineral which is absorbed as molybdenum ions, and the functions include: it is a major component of the enzymes like nitrogenase and nitrate reductase. The enzymes like nitrogenase and nitrate reductase helps in carrying out the process of nitrogen fixation. These enzymes are responsible for carrying out certain reactions in the process of nitrogen fixation. Therefore, it is also required for nodule formation. As I said you before, that the nodule can be formed only by the division of cortical cells. So, by the presence of molybdenum ions, the cortical cells of the root divide and it forms a nodule. And this nodule is accumulated by a bacteria called rhizobium, and this symbiotic association which is shown by the rhizobium with the nodule helps in carrying out the process of nitrogen fixation. The molybdenum ions also requires, or it also helps in the accumulation of amino acids. As they are required for the accumulation of amino acids, it results in the synthesis of protein. And it is required for ascorbic acid metabolism. Ascorbic acid is vitamin C, which is usually seen in the citrus plants. So this molybdenum ions is required to carry out the metabolism of ascorbic acid in the citrus plants. And this molybdenum ion is also essential for protecting and for maintaining the structure or an organelle called chloroplast. As it is required to maintain the structure of chloroplast, then if we see the deficiency of molybdenum ion, then in the deficiency symptom, we can observe the yellow spot disease of citrus fruit. In this disease, we see the patchy skin of the fruits, and this patchy skin is due to the improper structure of chloroplast in which the chlorophyll pigment is present. This chlorophyll pigment is responsible for carrying out the photosynthesis and also for imparting the green color. When this synthesis will get affected due to the deficiency of molybdenum, then we can see a yellow spot disease of citrus fruits, and we can also see the dieback of shoot in many plants due to the deficiency of molybdenum ions. And one particular disease which can only be seen in the cabbage is named as whip tail disease. The symptoms of this disease shows the leaves of the cabbage becomes longer. Normally we can see the broad leaves of the cabbage, and the bud is used, or the bud is utilized as a vegetable by us. And if the leaves normally the leaves are broader, but when the deficiency of molybdenum occurs in the plant, then the leaves of the cabbage becomes longer, which is unusual, which affects the economic value of the cabbage vegetable. The main deficiency symptoms of the molybdenum are yellow spot disease and whiptail disease, because the yellow spot disease is particularly seen only in the citrus fruits, and this whiptail disease is particularly seen only in the cabbage. There is no observation of whiptail disease, or we cannot observe the whiptail disease in other plants. Let's move to the next one, that is chlorine. Chlorine is an element which is absorbed as chloride ions, and along with this chloride ions, the sodium and the potassium ions are also getting absorbed. The functions of the chlorine include, it is essential for maintaining the ratio of anions and cations. That means it balances the osmotic pressure or the osmotic potential in the plant body by maintaining the ratio of anions and cations. And it also helps in the water splitting reaction. That means it helps in carrying out the photolysis, which I have already explained you in the other type of elements. And this chlorine is also responsible for carrying out the photolysis, water splitting reaction in photosynthesis. Now let us see what happens in the photolysis. The photolysis is a reaction of water in the presence of light. I told you that photosynthesis shows two types of reaction, light reaction and dark reaction. Now, during the light reaction, in the presence of light, the water is going to be split and give three things. The first is, it gives out two electrons, it gives rise to two protons, and also one molecule of oxygen. And this oxygen is a byproduct, and the electrons which is released by the splitting of water is carried to the chlorophyll of PS2, photophosphorylation 2. So this two electrons is carried to the chlorophyll of PS2 in order to proceed the reactions of photosynthesis. So the carrying of electrons, or the transportation of electrons after the splitting reaction to the chlorophyll, is going to be takes place through chloride ions. So the chloride ions are responsible to carry the electrons to the chlorophyll in order to proceed the reactions of photosynthesis. Now let us talk about the deficiency symptoms of chlorine. Usually we cannot see the deficiency symptoms. There are very rare deficiency symptoms that we can observe due to the absence or due to the deficiency of an element called chlorine, because there are many salts which we can found in the soil that contains chloride ions in it. So we are using a technique called hydroponic, in which we are using a nutrient medium without any soil. We are not using soil here, we are using nutrient medium, and by this technique we came to know about the deficiency symptoms of chlorine. Usually it is very rare, but by using the technique hydroponics, we came to know some of the deficiency symptoms that can be caused due to the absence of chloride ions. In the absence of chloride ions, the rate of the photosynthesis decreases, because the chloride ions are responsible to carry out the photolysis reaction. So if the chloride ions are not present, then the rate of the photosynthesis would get affected. And even as I said you in the functions of chlorine, that it helps in balancing the ratio of anions and cations. If the chloride ions are not present, if it is not available in the plant body, then the imbalance of the anions and cations takes place, that results in the wilting of leaves. The leaves becomes wilted due to the imbalance of anions and cations. And one more deficiency symptom that we can see due to the absence of chloride ions is necrosis that results in the death of the tissues. So these are certain symptoms which can be detected or which can be observed by using the technique hydroponics. Let us move to the last mineral, that is nickel. Nickel shows a specific function in the activation of urease enzyme. And this urease enzyme is responsible to convert this urea into carbon dioxide and ammonia, because the urea is a toxic material and this urea is going to accumulate in each or in various cells of the plant body. So the accumulation of urea can affect the plant body because it is toxic in nature. So this urea has to get converted into the non-toxic material, that is into carbon dioxide and ammonia. And this conversion of urea into carbon dioxide and ammonia takes place in the presence of urease enzyme, and this urease enzyme can only be activated in the presence of mineral called nickel. So nickel is playing a very important role in activation of urease enzyme that helps in carrying out the conversion of toxic material into the non-toxic in the plant body. The deficiency symptoms of nickel are necrosis. As we have seen in most of the elements, the necrosis is a common symptom that can be seen. So here also, due to the deficiency of nickel, the death of the tissues can take place, that can be termed as necrosis. The seeds of barley found to be abnormal in the deficiency of nickel. So these are certain functions and the deficiencies of some macro and some micro elements.